Guys, can you believe it? New FNAF action figures of characters that exist in this timeline. Sorry for yelling, I just thought I'd start on a positive note. It has been a very long time since we got a truly good FNAF action figure wave. And while I know other waves had some good quality, Sister Location is literally the last time we got a set of action figures that was based on a relevant game with relevant characters and were also a nice quality. Which was back in 2017!
Oh yeah!
Waves like the Security Breach and FNAF AR had trouble managing at least one of these requirements. So the fact that we actually have FNAF Ruin characters as action figures is amazing. The game was a lot of fun, and even though it wasn't my favorite FNAF game ever, I really enjoyed the puzzles and the atmosphere. And of course, I thought the characters were pretty cool too. Though not all our friends will be joining us, I have a few theories to why that is. But we'll get more into that later. I think we should at least open one of these first, so take it away, past me.
Hello everyone, it is I, Nuclear Nachos from the past, and I am so excited to actually have these. It's crazy that I got them this early, and if you're wondering how, well then, let me tell ya. If you guys ever see some of these figures come out way earlier, check your local collectible store. They might have something you weren't expecting, and that's pretty much what happened here. I actually got these as birthday presents, so that makes it even crazier. So yeah, let's get into it. And I just want to say right off the bat how crazy we got from these guys right here onto these guys in the back. Okay, well for Sun, it's not that surprising. That's a pretty nice transition. But these guys, oh boy, I'm excited to make some comparisons. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Starting off with Withered Chica. Wait, nope. Starting off with Ruin Chica, and oh my gosh, just inside the box already, there's so much detail. And we got the backside of the box, we can collect Chica, Roxy, and Eclipse. Not the, obviously, I wish there was more characters we could get, but you know, I'm honestly really happy with what we have right now. They look really cool. Alright, enough talking, let's actually open this. Obviously, can't save the box art, or the box at all. It's gotta be... Oh right, these have ties to them. We're gonna need some scissors. The best part about these is that if you break them or get them scuffed up, it'll just look like the thing. Okay, and let's take a look at her. Oh my gosh. Whoa. These are insane! Does her head not move? It's very stuck. Okay. Oh, and those are some really thin arms. It makes sense. It's accurate. It is insanely accurate. Got the no second arm. Oh my gosh. These are Oh my gosh. Let's look at the back end. Like, look at all like the dirt detail. And that's all sculpted in the skull. Wow. Yeah, they really did like some making up. These look incredible. And, you know, I have a long history on this channel of saying when things are bad, when things are good. And I can say for absolute certain, these are amazing. Look at the skull. Look at that, like, I can't believe it. Funko, you're insane. You did the impossible. Oh my gosh, this is so cool, actually. I'm actually so giddy about this because it's just so cool having really awesome action figures. And this is like beyond almost like even like the best of Funko. We'll do some comparisons in a second, but wow. All right, it's 10 out of 10, solid. I mean, here's a picture of a render of Glamrock Chica, so you can judge how accurate it is, but oh my gosh. Wow. All right. Great.
Ruin Chica, and oh my gosh, these figures are well made. The paint, the sculpt, it's all incredible. Just look at Chica's head. Look at all the 3D details that were put into this. They even got the trash bag in her stomach, which I didn't even notice until now. And while the figures are still being made in the same size as previous, they made them in a way that still feels like it captures the scale of how big the Glamrocks were. At least well enough. The articulation is great too. The only thing for me is I can't get the head to move, but it might just be a bit stuck. Overall, this figure is outstanding with how much detail it has. This is like something I'd expect from a hand-painted statue from some guy on YouTube, not an action figure you can buy for 15 bucks. Bravo, Funko.
Alright, and if we compare the two, it's night and day. Like, the eyes are different. They're not even the same color. The eyes are really, like, popping out. They're a lot bigger. Wow, Funko, I am so impressed and proud. This is nuts. Wow. All right, I guess it's time to... Oh my gosh, move on to the next one.
So low on health. Good thing I found this cake item. When did this game have cake? Oh hey, that was mine! Whatever. It's fine. I'm sure I can find it.
Thanks for standing still!
Alright, two more to go, and oh my gosh, like, Funko. Oh my gosh, and this one looks cooler. This is actually my favorite one in the set. Let's just open it. We'll do all the talking. That's future Nacho's job. My job is to get right into it. Yeah. Making these boxes ruined, more like it. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Oh, this is what I've become. Okay. Her head moves a bit more. I wonder why they don't move as well. They seem like they should. That's really my only, like, not really complaint, but, like, that's a bit odd. Got the legs. Now, I will say, the joints are interesting. They feel kind of loose, but they're staying in place, so technically, that's the best case scenario, because if it's loose, but always stays in place, then they're always the easiest to move without actually getting messed up. Do the handshake? Oh my gosh, guys. This is so cool. I think I have to say it. These are the best action figures Funko has ever made. I just, like, what? Is there really an argument here? Like, these are so well done. I can't, like, I wouldn't expect this quality from Funko typically, but Funko, good job, man.
Ruined Roxy, and oh wow, this might be my favorite. Finally, she gets the praise she always wanted. Just had to be a broken down marketable figure to receive it. Everything I said about Chica in terms of quality goes for these next two figures. They're just amazing. Look at the back. You can tell they did not skip out on any details, and even the tail moves. And one thing I noticed, guys, oh my gosh, she can sit, like actually sit, not the stupid half sit with the arms in the back, but actually be able to sit fully. I guess the lack of exoskeleton parts helps with the movement, huh? And can we take a second to appreciate the finer details? The mouth is actually a mouth. There's space in there. And the hair is so intricate, it's sick that they were able to pull that off. Once again, astounding.
Of course, then we have to compare the two Roxannes. Is this one actually taller? Yeah, this is actually bigger than the, like, taller overall. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Yeah, they really stepped it up. A part of me kinda wishes they went back and made better original ones, but then it kinda screws over whoever bought these originally, even if they do suck. But, you know, it's like, it's interesting to think about, in a way. But, hey, with the Ruin figures, it really does give them that second chance, but in, like, a more proper way. So, yeah. These are really cool. Yeah. You are nothing!
You know, it's funny, when I first saw these models, they didn't look too crazy. Just goes to show how big the difference between renders and reality makes sometimes. Which makes it really a shame we didn't get more of them. But let's think of why that might be. Theory 1. All the other characters wouldn't fit Funko's general body shape. As Ruin Freddy has a missing head, Ruin Monty has missing legs, and MXES just has this weird tail thing, and the Mimic is tall. They all have things that make them not the most ideal for an action figure for Funko's general gist, but they still totally could have done it. After all, Chica is missing a lower arm, and she still exists. The Ballora figure had a stand to help her stand, so they could have done that also. They made dumb Balloon Freddy despite him being barely taller than a Mystery Mini. So, it is possible. So, let's move on to Theory 2. Theory 2! FNAF Movie Wave! There's rumors of a FNAF Movie Wave coming out soon, and if that's the case, it kind of makes sense that Funko had to shorten this wave down to just a few characters. If they have to make a whole FNAF Movie Wave, it makes sense that they can't just make two full sets in 1 year. It also makes sense why this set came out a bit later. Usually Funko has a normal set release in spring-ish, and then a variant wave that reuses characters around in October. So maybe that's why everything has been so funky. Making these come out during the fall, or summer apparently, and then maybe we'll get the FNAF movie stuff near the winter. Which if that's the case, I think that's a fair enough reason to not make the other characters. That's a lot to do at one time. And then, of course, there's Theory 3, is simply, the characters are so complex that they could only do a few of them. Think about it. Ugh. Think about it. All of these characters have roughly the same detail as Scrap Baby, which was a build-a-figure in a wave where everyone else was a simple design. And these might actually look better than her now that I'm looking at them. It could be just that these characters were too complex to make too many of. So, I can see that too. It would be really cool if they made another wave to do some of the other characters, but honestly, I'm very happy we at least got these few.
Alright, and last up we have Eclipse. Now this is an interesting one, because as we all know, the Sun figure is actually really good on its own. Now, I don't have the Moon figure, by the way. I honestly didn't get it because I knew this figure was on the way. And then I was like, I don't really need them separately then. I also couldn't find it until like 2 days ago. So we'll have to see how much of an improvement is it when the base figure is already so good. Let's just open it. Wow, this guy is big. Oh gosh, he's like hard, he's really wired. Does he just have one? Oh wait. Oh, that's not a tie, that's just what his arm looks like. My bad. Oh gosh, this guy is scary. All right, he's got his full head movement. He's got the back wires, we'll do a comparison later. Got the hat, just, oh my gosh. All right, then we got the legs, which this one's just a little screw thingy, and then his pants are, geez, like, look at that paint. That's like really impressive paint, and all this like scratches, they're all molded. All right, how does he stand? Will he stand for this? He stands for it.
Eclipse, a very interesting figure. Unlike the last two, we already got awesome Sun and Moon figures. We already knew how an awesome figure of this character could look. And it ironically does make this guy a bit less impressive to me, just because the bar for him was already set pretty high. But hey, that doesn't take away at all from how cool it is to have this guy like this.
Overall, it's an amazing representation of the character. It has all the details and all the spaces just like all the others. It has all the paint, all the 3D sculpting. It definitely keeps that quality the other ones do. It's just not as big as a leap from a previous figure. So that's pretty awesome. And of course, it's got great articulation, especially in the head. Very amazing.
All right, of course, now we have to do the comparison. So, if I ever need Moon for a video, I'll just use Eclipse. It's close enough. It's definitely hard getting him to stand, but like, it's like, hey, would you rather accuracy or standing? All right, as you can tell, very similar we got over here. Let's zoom in a bit. Hello? All right. And yeah, so basically, just a lot more scratches, and obviously the things that make Eclipse. And yeah, just really great, solid figure. Yeah, and look at the back, very different colors. Holy crap, guys. These are amazing. I love these so much.
All right, that's it. It's time we take out these zombified imposters. Yeah! We got company! Okay, bring it on! Ja! Haha, you fool. Everyone knows I'm the best. You think that now, but there's no way for you to win. Oh yeah? Why is that? The creator of this video likes us more. No, this can't be. No, no!
Wow, what an amazing set of action figures. I am a collector, so I don't say this lightly. These may be the best action figures I own. Despite some very minor issues and differences from the original game models, these are the most perfect and accurate representations of these characters I could possibly imagine, and maybe the best FNAF action figures in the entire series of Funko. These entirely make up for the first security breach wave, and while I know not all the characters have been redeemed, I'm just happy that we even got the three characters that we did. Compare these guys with the previous Build-A-Figures that were known to be the most detailed in the entire series. And honestly, I think these figures may be better than those, Ennard being the only one I'm not too sure of. But those lack of eyebrows aren't doing him any favors. So guys, let me know in the comments below what you think of these action figures. I definitely believe that overall, this might be some of the best FNAF merchandise we have. And I could not recommend these figures enough. If you have any desire to pick these up, I'd say they're worth it. Even if they're like a lot of money on eBay down the line, I still think they will hold their value for quite a while. Maybe not like $200 or whatever, but you know. And I know Funko might not be making action figures for Five Nights at Freddy's anymore with the new licenses that were announced, but if so, then well, I'm glad they're going out with a bang. With all that said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!